Hello everybody and welcome to Train Simulator 2016. As you can see, right in front of us, we will be driving this very 9F on a heavy freight mech, haul freight mechs. It says, welcome aboard this 9F mixed goods train to Kingmoor. You must head out quickly to avoid disrupting an express passenger service behind you. We will be checking your timetable as you pass through each station on the way. So yes, I thought, when we come back onto Train Simulator 2016, we haven't driven a steam engine for a while. Sorry about that, excuse me. We haven't driven a steam engine for a while, so I thought, let's get back on a steam engine pass, and I thought this would be one of those scenarios that'd be worth giving it a go. So, as it said, we're get our reverser into gear. Send the cogs open. Put the lights on. Take those brakes off. Deafening under this bridge. Green light ahead though. Yes, after the last week's video of driving a bus on OMSI 2, I thought I'd go back onto Train Simulator. I've been cutting about and I'll probably be putting another video of hopefully next week of OMSI 2 again for you all. I've also been thinking of doing a video of Cities in Motion, Cities in Motion 2 I should say. I found like a workshop room map of Cardiff and I've been having a look at that lately and it looked really good and interesting. I thought I might actually give that a go for us all to enjoy. If we get a lovely view of the you like on here. Yeah, that beautiful chime whistle that you can whistle along with. Of course, this has a steam sound pack on it, which actually adds some beautiful sound realism to it that you normally would get with the more standard version. So, yeah, recommended again. Well, I can finally see the end of our tree. Way down there, the gather. Still got a bit to go, speeding up. Our train is limited, I should say, on here. Did read on the thing, we are limited to 45 miles per hour, so won't be exceeded over that. So this will be a long haul run all the way to Kingmoor. Let's have a look at the stuff we're going to go buy by. Our first buyer is via Rack's Platform 1 for Bob Platform, Cummer Trees Platform, Anna's Platform, all the way to Gret the Green, and then Kingmoor site. So, we've got a few little runs we got to go. Not slipping, so that's good enough. Take the cylinder cogs off now. So a bit more power on her. Got the train coming the other way, great. Definitely not as big and heavy as us. A very big, heavy engine here. So we're running very well along here now. Getting a bit more welly on her. I love playing with that one. Yeah, I'm not too sure what days I would upload them. So that's what I'm stuck with at the moment. Thinking of doing it, but don't know when I would upload it and this, that, the other. And if I would have, like, a lot of time to do a lot of it, you know, part of these videos. Sometimes I do struggle to get some of these videos done. You know, I'm lucky to get some time to do them. So, I'm not too sure. I don't know what will happen yet. Sad one to work out. But when I do, I will let you know. I'll probably upload a video. So you can all enjoy. Enjoy it. Oh. Whole experience, because I think one thing City in Motion is it's got all worlds, it's got everything there. It's got like a bus, you've got a tram, the train, the boat. as well. Which I thought, yeah, it was something good for my channel. Something that probably people would enjoy watching. Watching quite a bit of intent. Such a lovely engine, this. But no, that's like I said, it's not everything for everyone, really. See, like, originally I did say train fever, and I might do one of train fever, I just haven't really. When I got fraps going on it, it didn't really want to record it properly. Which, it's not the best. You know, I need to record a software that will record it. About like messing around so much with him. And City Motions, I can't do it without messing around at all and everything. So it has a lot of its positives. So that's why I thought of this. And yeah, I didn't know what people, what else everyone else would think about it. That'd be a good idea, a bad idea, well, and would you enjoy watching, like, series on that? So, yeah, I'm not too sure. But, yeah, please, if you have an opinion on that, or actually, what do you think, please don't hesitate. Leave a comment below, in the video, or even sending it on Facebook. Twitter. Make a good time and continue on to Roofwell Platform 1. So we got a bit of points there, probably not a lot of what we could have had. But yeah, you know, we are putting our foot down now. It's going to go, getting us going. Really go along and see what we got all together. I should leave that up. Okay, good a rank of wagons behind us. We haven't got a tail up now, so told off. Technically told off for that. Slightly gradient I can see coming up on the gradient profile. But I don't think it's going to be too much of a gradient, to be honest. Slowly coming up to our speed restriction on this engine. It's slight like lag where you put your down saying accelerate or telling it to regulate it on or off. But you tap the button and you've got to wait a bit before you'll actually activate doing it. So you've got to bear in mind like the slight like delays between one and the other. as long as you can watch that out, you'll be fine driving this engine. As much with this steep sound screen town pack, makes it so much realistic and what a nice engine to drive along. Never engine coming the other way. It's number 9 here. Passenger set. The caravan on the back is quite interesting. Quite an interesting like combination that was. So yeah, we're on the gradient now at 1 in 50. Got a bit more acceleration on to help us climb this a bit better. I lose too much speed. Now we have a very heavy haul freight engine here. We're supposed to arrive at our next station at 12:15. It is 12:18, so we're going to probably be a little bit late. But hopefully it won't penalise us too much. We are pretty much doing the speed that we're limited to on this engine, 45 miles per hour. So we can't really go up too much more than that. Get penalised for doing so. Even if this engine is very capable to do it, it's not going to do it. I think we're just slightly behind time. We're a bit cautious in starting up. You have to be a bit brutal to actually get a decent score on this scenario. Really, I wasn't that brutal enough because I didn't want it to slip or anything like that. Because of course you get minus, you lose points if she slips. Okay, that's interesting. Petrol liquid. Green light, so all right. Still on time, carry on to a couple of trees at launch. So that gave us some points. Probably won't get too many points, and there goes a cockball in the distance then. What time is it? 12 o'clock and you got a cockball still doing the morning for us. Quite interesting. So we're running quite nicely along now. How are we doing to the next station? There's no ET. There's no actual time we need to be. very good. If you love your driving along with steam trains or even old British railways, if you look like the old VRDA trains and everything, I would. This route is old, but I would recommend it. It's a very good route, very long, a lot of stuff to do. To go from one side of the route to the other, it will take a good 2 hours. So that pretty much tells you what this route is like. Quite nice, interesting little route to try along. I haven't done a video on this route. I've always wanted to try and do a video on this route, actually. excuse me. I never got the chance to do it, so I'm glad I'm doing this video now, running along with it. Cattle train going the other way. Yeah, I'm quite glad I got around doing it now. So we can all enjoy this beautiful run as we go along, and I thought I'd do it on a freight train as well. We really don't do much freight services, if you've noticed, or passenger, but I thought I'd do a lovely freight service, a very heavy water train. Experience in that. Well, we're not really hammering out boiler pressure, having a nice steam PSI going through as well, so, and we're running quite nicely. You wouldn't really want to be doing very good on our run. 9F coming the other way, on tankers. Up on the back of there. Nice temperature of a cheese. No delays reported from the passenger service. Platform 1 is your next checkpoint. Excuse me. That's the only thing with the window open. You're gonna... I'm sorry about this. Sneezing a bit. I have my window open at the moment. Well, like I said, it's boiling hot. Weak lately. And very humid and muggy. Computer's also rampant, like there's no tomorrow on the fan. Of course, blowing out a lot of heat. But you're lucky, I normally have my little desk fan going off as well. But I thought I'd turn that off just in case blows too much wind into the mic. Right, let's get this. Get the injectors on. So yeah, we have a nice little run down now. Lights ahead. going back to speed limit now. So that's our restricted speed. I should say speed limit, you can see 75 miles per hour. Lovely. Vomit at that speed. I'll let you have enjoy another flyby on the train. The speed limit goes out to 45, so we won't be slowing down for that. That's the speed we're actually doing. I love the look down here. Fish and ship boats. Look down there. Beautiful view. Right, coming into an A station. Anna station, whatever it's pronounced, sorry about that. How pronounced it. Late, of course. Let's see how all the points we get. I'm not getting much points because, well, we're running late anyway. General to the points in store. But we're doing a good old run as it is. We're not running too late. We're not disrupting the train behind us early. And we're not breaking the speed limit with these wagons, so I'm not going to really complain too much at that. Slowly creeping up still. I did kind of abandon it for a bit then. Stopping now. Lovely curvature on the bends. See the train curves into the bends. I really love this ride. Lovely route. Right, that's an amber light. Oh, it's just gone up. Just got. Only just got clearance to the sections. Yeah, that's going uphill. love playing around with that whistle. Of course, you can't be noticed. Tractor waiting right there. Farmer. So yeah, nice little run down this has been. Have not really pulled up that distance because not all the section was clear. Because that would have to gone up as well, all the four sections. Still, time is still on your side. Continue towards Gretna Green. Love it, like it's got that, this route always got that look, like end of BR days, kind of the really kind of like an abandoned type of look. Like, not being, well not abandoned, but like, not really loved anymore. Used much. We're running quite nicely along here now. Not too far away. Miles. 74 miles to go. I don't know if you can hear me too much on this safety valve keeps going on. They're not very noisy. But I'll do keep trying to speak loud enough for it. Pretty dark in here. Like it needs a slight update on the texture of everything. That's the thing, when I don't know what it is, but when each train, they have like a train out for such a long time, after a while it looks a bit after the cab, and also the it normally looks very, very dark in the cab than it would be. I don't know why, it just does. I think it's just the way they keep updating the software year to year. In the end, they do feel like slightly neglected, like just no longer loved anymore. Which is a shame. But, like I said, hopefully, I get a little bit of loving and caring sometimes and get a bit of an update. Some of them really do need. that tight little update on him. I keep putting the wrong buttons. I keep, like, obviously in Omzi. Because to get back into the cab in Omzi, you've got F1. F1 just gives you the menu here on this. And, yeah, you have to push one. Well, if you push one in Omzi, you don't really do much. Maybe abandoned platform. Nicely going along. Coming up to a mile and a half to Gretna Green. Should have gone through there already by now, but there we go. River, look at the boat. I've driven this train for such a long time. I quite enjoy leaving my head out on the cab on this thing. It's a lovely engine to cab your heads out on. Posted all up, posted it along now. It's just a big, big heavy engine this is. Don't want to do that. Are we in a bus as well? Classic bus. Just lies ahead of you. Bring the train to a halt outside the yard. So, that's that. This is the signal. Ladies and gentlemen, this is just going to be going to run back on Train Simulator 2016 on a steam train. Been a steam train for a while. Just enjoying the sounds of this beautiful engine. Steam sounds supreme. Now, Gretna Junction, about that. Sorry about that. Forgot that I had the ejector skull on. Find the engine. We lost all our points then. Synchronization issues then. I'm trying to slow us down, obviously. It doesn't have like a notch where you just sit there, because I didn't put it on just run. Normally that self-regulates it. There we go, I bet it's sick. The cylinder cogs up because we'll find the engine. And well, sped that one time. Yeah, you know, just the whole thing that we ended up here, actually sped. But there we go. We've got a stop, because it's just a stop marker, that's all, so... Stop it to go for the helicopter. Guard van, shall we? Interesting view, wasn't it, from the guard van? Fail us completely this. I don't blame it. Just a bit. But it's not total. So better than was expecting a lot of it. I've been doing this for such a long time. Staying there. It's not too loud, but that's something that's going on with speed. Yeah, we're just running along quite nicely along here now. enjoying the speed restriction coming up, so. Slow down for that now already. This engine doesn't have EWS, in looking at it, so... I guess it's some do, some don't. But I was expecting the standard classes to have it. Especially this one, because it's a late standard class. It's the last one of them making. Right, let's get the brakes on. No, temperamentally. Still in ulti mode there. And that's the thing, it's very hard. I'm trying to remember, like, going from one simulator to the other. I see our stop marker. Far away now. Probably on that bridge there. Slipping up the other. Still going too slow. Not gaining anything out and stuff. There we actually stand and move up with it. Get a bit of traction on her. Get the sander on her as well. Stop slipping so much. Get her up that hill. It's a nice sound she makes. Get to the crest of the hill and that's where I'll slow her down and stop her. Because got red light ahead, Dad. I want to press. Stuck on top of the bridge. So we're slowing down again. Must be more of our weight on the braking again. There we go. Well, that's it, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you enjoyed that little run on the 9F. I do like that. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed our little... leave it like that. Hope you enjoyed our little run on the 9F. Sorry it wasn't the best little run. Not a good score. Good job. As soon as the signal clears, these goods will be... categorized into Kingmoor Yard before continuing their journey. So yeah, one best run, especially on a steam engine. Sorry about that. I haven't really driven the steam engine for a while, like I said, on, well, probably seen on my videos. It's not been one, it's got to be a good old month, over a month ago since the last time we drove a steam engine on this route, on this game. So it's been a while. But yeah, no, I thought I'd give it a good old run today. But yeah, like hopefully enjoyed it. Back on Train Simulator. People that like watching OMSI 2 videos, I will be uploading another OMSI 2 video next week. I'll let you keep you informed. What do I do if I do a CT Motions 2 video? We'll be uploading that one as well. So yeah, I think that's pretty much it. All is left to say is please don't forget to, if you enjoyed this video, please put a like next to it. It just makes me know that people enjoy these videos and enjoy the work I'm doing. If you have anything you would like to ask, a comment, or anything at all, please don't hesitate. Leave a comment below, and I'd be happy enough to read them and get back to you as soon as I can. There's also a link in my description of my Facebook and Twitter group pages. If you'd like to follow me on them, please do so, and you can also send messages on them to me, and I'll be happy enough to reply. So that's it then. So hopefully you enjoyed that. Like I said, OMSI 2 next video. I'll let you know, keep you posted if I do a City in Motions 2 video, and run through on that. So that's it, ladies and gentlemen. So hope you enjoyed, and thanks for watching. Bye for now.